Chris, you're drinking brandy? Is everything okay?
Yeah, I guess I just really needed one today.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I've been having that kind of week myself. Chris, we need to talk.
Yes, we do.
We do?
Yeah, and I think I should start, so why don't you have a seat?
Okay. What's the problem?
Diane, these last few months have been really hard.
Yeah, Chris, I know. It's me mismanaging.
Can you please just let me finish?
Sorry.
Now, I have tried to be supportive and stick by you, but I still feel like I've been doing nothing but coming up short. Everything that I do is wrong. Nothing I say is right. And half the time, you're too engrossed in your work to even notice me at all. And when you do, it's like you're not even speaking to me. Diane, I've been so lonely. And I'm not just talking about only physically, but Diane, you're my best friend. You're my best friend, and you haven't even been here for me to talk to. And sometimes it feels like we're just nothing more than roommates. I mean, we try, and still, there's no connection, Diane. There's no connection whatsoever.
Hey, baby, and it's not just you. Look, I've been walking around all night thinking the exact same thing. And, you know, I think that if we just start...
Diane, I've been having these meetings with one of my client's assistants. We met at the anniversary dinner. Mm-hmm. You know, it's my firm is doing something with their company and over some account.
Yeah, you have lunch meetings all the time.
Well, this assistant is a woman. And she's a very beautiful woman. And it just became this regular thing, you know? At the same time, every week, at the same place, that little bistro right up the street. And we would get together, and we would work and talk, and, you know, we would work a little more and just talk and talk and talk.
Don't even.
Well, tonight we had another meeting. Only this time it wasn't at the bistro. It was at a hotel. Hey.
Chris, God, so fully get your hands off me.
Diane, nothing happened.
Oh, nothing
right?
happened?
No, nothing happened.
Then what
happened.
Did you do, Chris?
Listen, we just held each other and we just kissed a little bit. But listen, Diane, I have been so lonely and I've needed you.
Haven't... Okay. Wow. You needed what? You needed to have an affair? You needed to desecrate our vows, our marriage for what? For some young, hot assistant?
It never even went that far, all right?
Oh, it didn't go that far. So you wanted it to go further, huh? Is that what it is, Chris? So why don't you follow through? I mean, come on, why don't you seal the deal? Oh, you couldn't get it up.
Oh, come on, Diane, give me a break. Because I was thinking about us, okay? Because I was thinking about you and all that we've been through these past few months.
Yeah, good timing.
I needed you, and you've just been so busy.
Oh, you poor thing. I mean, here I am, working my tail off, unable to cater to your every need.
Okay, I didn't mean it like that,
okay,
right?
Well, you know what? It doesn't even matter.
Diane, we need to talk about this.
Why? You've already made your choice.
Do you know how tough all this has been on me?
Oh, yeah, I'm sure it has been torture.
You're not even listening to me, Diane! Diane!
Okay, would you just let go of me?
Diane, I'm not leaving this house. This is our house, and I'm not going anywhere.
Okay, you know what?
We need to talk.
Chris, I have been unhappy for a long time, too. And I came back here tonight so that we could talk about it, so that we could figure out where we went wrong and try to salvage our marriage for us and for the sake of our... You know what? It doesn't even matter. Nothing matters. And you know what? From now on, I'm just gonna look out for me.
I'm not losing you, Diane. Not over this.
I knew what I had to do all this time. And maybe I was stupid, or maybe I was foolish. But you know what, Chris? I have to thank you. I have to thank you for making it so easy for me to have to say goodbye. Goodbye, Chris.